Okay, so yeah, thank you, Giovanni. All right, let's see if we can call this motherfucker. I'm gonna go over here and you guys are gonna hear some little Michael. Hi, Michael. Yeah, Raze, we got one more D1 video coming. 2 week bid or what, man? Baby Ripka, what up?
Get a full $1,200 check from the government.
Hello, hello.
Hello, hello. We're gonna put you over here. $8,000. You get a check. There you go.
What's going on, man?
I hear you in the background. I hear you getting a $1,200 check from the government.
Oh, you know what? You caught me checking, man. You caught me checking up on my money, man.
I was glad, man. I'm behind on my taxes. I didn't think I was gonna get one.
Yeah, I mean, I guess everybody gets it. You know, we all need it.
Unless you're on back child support, you don't get it.
Right, and then they'll take 12 off of your stack.
Oh, they are?
Money. Oh, I don't know. Maybe not. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, Sage, one of the followers that are going to give some subs, they need to gift you some subs because you have a Twitch. Tell everybody your Twitch.
Oh, yeah. My Twitch is Ubiquitwitch. This is UBIQUITWITCH, Ubiquitwitch.
Ubiquitwitch.
Yeah, I'm just a little baby. I just started my Twitch channel maybe a month ago.
But I heard you have more viewers than I ever had one day because Tech tweeted you out.
Tech maybe tweeted me out, but they had put me on the cover.
Oh, they put you on the front page.
They put me on the front page, which really I think is what it was. And there was a lot of people in my chat that were like, you're fake. This is Fugazi. There's like thousands of people in here. You know, they're all fake viewers, fake news. They call me fake news.
Dang, bro. Welcome to Twitch, man. Welcome to cyberspace.
Hey, I'm happy to be here, man. I thought I was winning. I was like, fake news on my first day. Let's go.
Yeah, man. Word to the president.
Yeah, where's the president?
Vic hit me up with a lot of shit. How was your trip to TwitchCon? He wants me to ask you.
TwitchCon was super fly. I had no idea what I was getting into. It was like as involved as a Comic-Con, as the biggest Comic-Con I've ever been to. It was that involved, if not more involved. The fanaticism was crazy. Everybody's streaming, like everybody's like running around, like doing like live streaming ring backpacks. You know what I'm saying? Interviewing each other.
I don't give a there fuck. Was, I'm working.
There were stars, you know. There was like, like high profile people. This big keynote speech where they were like rolling out the future of Twitch, which I thought was very interesting. It was tight, man. It was tight. I was really inspired, actually. I hadn't been that inspired. I felt like I was like at the Tony Stark Expo. You know what I'm saying? Like it felt like the future. You know, it was tight.
Tony Stark. Yeah, it does feel like, what's that shit called? The World's Fair.
Yeah. It felt like that.
But it's not fair.
It's not fair. Ain't shit fair out here, boy.
So everybody wants to know who you are. This is Ubiquitous of Cess Crew. He is an MC. Living in Kansas City, representing KC by way of Colorado?
Big facts. Born and raised in the Denver, Colorado area. And then I've been living in Kansas City a long time. That's where I kind of cut my teeth rapping.
What does that saying, cut your teeth, mean? What does that mean?
I don't know. I guess I always took it like on some like baby stuff. You know, like when the babies is cutting, when they're cutting teeth.
Oh, they're cutting teeth. I get it. Yeah, my baby's cutting teeth right now. Ah,
it's hell.
Thank you.
It's hell, right? It's hell for them.
Yeah.
And by extension.
Yeah, and this guy is overweight as well, so it's really difficult for him.
Oh, dang. You got to give him one of those cold things. Here, gnaw on this cold plastic for a while.
He eats everything.
Tight. Tight.
So I wasn't supposed to ask you this, but since we're talking about who you are, you rap. You're known for rapping with a black guy.
Big facts. Got him.
How did that happen?
How did I get to rap with a black guy?
Well, both, yeah. And how do you feel about Run the Jewels stealing your shit?
Man, they kind of took our whole black-white situation.
Yeah, man. The whole Oreo cookie situation was stolen. You know, or did we steal that? That's did Felt steal that from you as well?
Felt, this MC Merz and this other MC Slug snatched up our shit. You know, Eminem and Royce da 5'9" stole our shit. Everybody be stealing our shit for years, man. And I just want credit at the end of it. You know what I'm saying? It's a blessing. Like, you know, I feel like emulation is the highest form of flattery. So I just want to, you know, just big me up. Hey. When you get your Grammys, M.
Yeah, you know. Shout out to Sesku for pioneering this.
Pioneering.
What is that shit called when the chocolate vanilla shake? What was that shit called back in the day?
I don't know, but it was great.
Siri, what do you call a chocolate vanilla shake? She doesn't want to. Hey Siri, what do you call a chocolate and vanilla shake? Let's see what this bitch has to say.
Just a sec. Siri.
Oh, she said pause.
Okay, I found this on the web for what do you call a chocolate and vanilla. Check it out.
Never mind.
What?
A swirl. It used to be called something back in the day. I don't know. We don't have no soda jerks in the house.
Swirl? That's the best she could come up with?
Yeah, nah. She's whack, bro.
I thought Siri was exotic.
Oh, man. I can't even think of him now. Anyway, I'll come back to that. It's like called like a brown cow or something. What is it called?
A brown cow? There's no way it's a brown cow. Brown cow?
How now, brown cow? I don't know, man.
Dang. Oh, man. It's shit like that to get shot down in development meetings. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I need a board of people to like just tell me that's a bad idea.
Right.
Brown cow.
Or if it's depending on your team, you know what I'm saying? Your whole team might get behind that shit and they walk out like, damn, brown cow? Wow. How come nobody spoke up?
Nobody's got the brown cow. And then you end up like, what's that called? HMV with the little black kid in the monkey t-shirt.
Like, oh my God.
When big corporations do that, I'm like, how does that happen? How does that get to that? No one said, hey, maybe bad idea.
Somebody was supposed to catch that. That was crazy.
Yeah, so yeah. All right, moving on. What do you appreciate about streaming?
What do I appreciate about it? You know, I don't know. Streaming's cool. I like the immediateness of it.
Yeah.
I've done some planned streams and those have been fun. I've done some random streams and those have been super fun. I'm like, oh, I'm just gonna go live, you know, and just see what happens. I love the spontaneity of it. The connectivity of it is really cool. It's interesting, man. I feel like Twitch might be the streaming platform of the future.
Yeah, man. You know? I definitely, you know, I pioneered this for you like you pioneered mixed race rap groups, you know.
Big facts. You came before me.
Pause.
Oh. Yo. Wow. Yeah, big pause.
That's all right. Big up yourself, though. You know what I'm saying? I'm the premature ejaculator here. You're the man with stamina, you know? Cool, bro.
Wow. That's they prefer that in these streets out here, the stamina. They prefer that.
Yeah,
that
hurt, man.
Mm-hmm. Good,
too bad for my wife.
Right. Sorry.
What is the somebody wants to know, do you use the PS4?
I do use the PS4. Yep.
What is your game of choice at the moment?
More than anything, I've been playing Apex Legends.
Okay.
Right now. Generally I almost like left the whole first person shooter genre behind, although when we were on tour on Mers Day we were playing it frequently in the back of the bus. We were playing
Call. Do you remember that one time Sarah Dope came on the bus and we murdered her, and you know, then she started, you know, complaining about the controller. She didn't have her Astro headphones, it wasn't fair. You remember that?
I remember something like that. I think it might have been exactly how you just told it.
Yeah.
Is how, you know? Yeah. I remember to myself, you know, when I played her Call of Duty back then, I'm like, oh, she nice. You know what I'm saying? She not fucking with me.
Exactly.
But she nice. I see exactly. How she's nice in these streets.
You know,
she's got a shot. The shot is wet. You know what I'm saying? But
not this nice.
Nah, there's levels.
You know,
there's
not level. Team Strange nice. You know, but being that she was representing Rhymesayers at the time, we kind of took it easy on her.
Right, right. I was trying to make friends. I think that was the first time I met Sarah Dope was that day. We have a Twitter relationship before that. Trivial. That's trivia there.
There's a guy named Marmo Films. That, by the way, that's all lies. Sarah beat us all.
She really is good.
She's really good at the game.
She's really good at the game.
The good thing we said that because she came in chat with, and today is the last day of our friendship.
Damn, I knew she was listening. I knew she was going to catch us on the bullshit.
There's some dude, Marimo, oh, Marmo Films 23.
Films.
He wants to know if he can shoot a video for you.
I mean, you know, send me your demo reel. If you nice like that.
Yeah. We'll see what
we put you in. Put you in play. We put you in play.
You know, that's right. You know what I'm saying? Looking out for the future. what we have here is a video called Read 'em and Weep, and we're going to play it a little bit online because Bomb Shelter laced us.
Marimo Films.
Marimo Films did this. we got a new setup now, so I'm going to try to work it. Is it worth it? Well, let me work it. Put my thing down, flip it, and reverse it.
You can play a video right now? You can do all kinds of cool shit, huh?
Yep, look at this. All right, here we go. This is called Read 'em and Weep.
By Marimo Films. Song. Oh, this is my song. Produced by Leonard Destroy.
Who is that?
Leonard Destroy is a hip-hop producer based in Kansas City, Missouri. He's kind of like our core, Chess Crew's core producer. Let me get this verse out. Pretty strange. I ain't ever
turned down. You know what I see in the background, which is weird for TwitchCon for me, is that back when I was going to these, it was before IRL streaming was a real big deal. And so everywhere you step in this video, there are people streaming from TwitchCon. I didn't get that. So, you know, meta, to be at TwitchCon streaming on Twitch. Like, before they used to have, like, setups where you could go stream booths. But now everyone's IRL streaming. So you shooting this video, you were on other people's streams, right?
I was in their streams. I was getting a lot of mixed reviews. Like, some people were like, oh, what's this dude doing? And then some people were like, oh, I'm in somebody's thing. And then they would, like, perk up like they're in, you know what I'm saying? And then other people would be like, this motherfucker just put me in his shit, and they were irritated. So it was this nice mix, because we didn't, you know, we just kind of shot it.
Let me just put it. Push play. Never took a break, never burned out, never look away when my fate didn't work out, never hesitated, never fake.
So am
when
I gonna be able count, to never worry about what they say with know the that slur it's on here at least? Place at the
pace I prefer. Can you hear it or see it? That killer pale
face you heard. I can't see it. Mouth, bro, if it's on I can't hear it. There's an untold
toll that it take on your soul. Yeah, they serving french fries cake with the pie. I've been serving up porterhouse steak with the side of orange grape. Your grape just served up porterhouse steak on survival in this game. I would stake on your life. Hey, and it's staked on my life. Faith in your guy waiting Christ he turn four lakes in the five. Great. Turn another four lakes in the five. Another game show. I'm on my grind date, working on my angles. When angels cry, I put on my raincoat. Thinking life is all sugar coated rainbows.
I'm in the same boat, pushing Twitch, things slow. Like. You
reap what yeah, give me a follow, bro. I'm on Twitch. Play the
game now. I already follow. I've been following you.
They want to get
up in the game. My whole be a star. Path through the game. And they complain about the cards. I'm just in your wake. You're like a speedboat. I'm just like a little inner tube in your speedboat way. The killer city committee chair. I'm very rare, ubiquitous in the UBI. I'm everywhere. I show up wearing a suit and tie. Oh, I see what it looks like here. Whoever there with heavy stairs, where the party at?
Oh, you got it like you got it laid out real sick. Whoever tripping, they need to bury and dedicate. Whoever scared can go to church. I said a prayer. Does oh shit, I fucked up, y'all. Sorry. Hold on, I brought it back. Hold on, I'm trying to find out where we were. Oh shit.
Uh oh, bring it back now.
Right, I got excited, man. Does Annie Milonakis smell as bad as he looks?
Nah, Annie didn't smell, man. I got close, too, and I didn't have any kind of experience with no foul male body odor. You know what I'm saying?
All right.
Shout out to Annie Milonakis. Shout out to personal hygiene.
Did he charge you for being in it?
What's up?
Did he charge you for being in it?
Nah, nah, he was just streaming too, bro. He'd probably been streaming for 18 hours straight. Who knows, you know what I'm saying? His left arm was like falling off. He was holding the streaming camera on his arm, you know what I'm saying? He had a rig on. You look like the merchant in Star Wars. You know what I'm saying? you look like you got a lot of shit on. You look tired, bro.
Which merchant in Star Wars?
I don't any merchant, you know. Any, when wow, you go to that, one, like
a random like, Star Wars merchant. Wow.
Right. When you on not dang, which planet are we talking about? Your Tatooine, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Called a Tatooine merchant.
A Tatooine merchant.
Yeah. That's what he looked like.
Do you have
he
any tattoos, by the way?
Zero tattoos. I'm clean, baby. I'm tattoo clean.
Tattoo free. What is mm-hmm. the thought process behind that?
You know, I never seem to have the time. I might be a bitch. I may just have an aversion to pain. It's hard to say, you know what I'm saying? Because I've never done it. But I do have aspirations to get some tattoos. I know you have some very tight tattoos. I really like your Mike Tyson tattoo.
Oh, thank you, bro.
For example.
I appreciate it, man.
But I've never taken the time to do it, but I do have aspirations, for getting some pretty ill sleeve work done. I've been searching for the right person. And it's going to be like a magical connection between me and the artist.
Okay. I like that. You're looking for someone to connect with. You should get Tattoo Tinder.
Is that a thing? Is that Tattoo Tinder?
Tattoo Tinder is a thing.
Does that imply like we tat and then we like, we go tit for tat? It's tat for tit.
Maybe you show your tits, you get a tat. I don't know.
They show tits, I get a tat. Let's go.
Hold on, I'm going to go back. That video is called Read 'Em and Weep, and if you want to watch it, it's on YouTube. Go watch it. It's a great video. Oh, shit. Now I just got rid of him. Now you're back.
Dang.
Marley B cries with every tattoo he gets.
Wow. I bet I would be like that. I bet I would be one of these crying-ass dudes. I bet I would bow out too. They'd be like, okay, we're going to go 9 hours on your sleeve today. And I would be like, after like 2.5 hours, I'd be like, I can't take it.
Time out.
Yeah. I'm just imagining, I don't know. Maybe there's like advances in tattooing where like, you don't have to feel the pain. I have no idea how the fuck you tell me. When's the last time you got a tattoo, Merz?
2 years ago.
Hurt like 2 years
bitch.
Ago.
Yeah. On my neck. I can hurt like a bitch.
Yeah. On the neck.
Oh, thank you, Seth. Seth got a tattoo. Oh, yo. Now I'm back to my question list. Yo. What has he been up to since getting off tour with Wax and Skywalker? First of all, who is Wax and Skywalker?
Oh, okay. So I went on tour in fall and winter of 2019 with Wax, who's a West Coast artist. I mean, I guess he's from Baltimore originally, but he lives in LA now. And then Lance Skywalker, who's like a Chicago dude, but he linked up with Top Dog Entertainment and he kind of runs with their little clique. So that was our tour. And it was tight, man. It was a really different tour, which felt good for me because I had done a lot of strange tours, like a lot back to back. Strange lineup, strange tours or whatever. And so this was a departure from that and it was tight. I very much enjoyed it. Good group of people to tour with. Cool people. Do you know Wax, Merz?
Nah, don't know Wax.
Oh wow. I'm surprised. Y'all probably been in the same room at a party or something.
No, we've met. I just don't know him.
Oh, you have met. Okay.
I think we've shooken hands, but I've never. Is it shaking or shooken?
I'll take either, you know.
Either way, there's no more of that shit happening.
I know. Yeah, we don't shake anymore. You stay over there with that. You
LeBron like James said he's never high-fiving again. RIP the high five.
RIP the high five. RIP holding hands, you know.
RIP holding hands unless it's with your main chick. That's going to be better than sex because sex you could use a condom. Like if you hold hands with a chick, that's going to be huge.
You know I love you. You know this true love. Because
I am holding.
We got our fingers intertwined like this. You know what I'm saying? You know.
Oh man. What is, so wait, hold on, I'm gonna see. I guess I don't want to ask any this question, but I'm gonna ask it because Vince wrote Vince Vic, Vince Vic McMahon, Vic Sandoval McMahon.
McMahon.
Do you think the current state of things is a good time to write? Is it fuel?
You know, no, not, I mean, at least I can't speak for everybody, but for me, no, I don't think it's fuel for me. It's tumultuous. I kind of have a routine. Like I take it in for an hour from like 8 to 9 every morning. I just like take in the current events and the current state of affairs or whatever, but it definitely doesn't make me want to sit down and like write the ill quarantine raps or nothing. That hasn't struck me. What about you? Are you feeling?
Hell no, man.
Writing Corona raps.
I'm trying to write rap for my Patreon right now, and I'm just like, ugh, man, it's so hard. It's taking me so long to write this little freestyle that I'm working on. Not tight, man.
It's not tight. Did you hear what Rec drop? Rec dropped some ill shit.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to get with that, man. I'm gonna have to listen to that for inspiration.
It was very cool. It was, you could tell he probably wrote it 3 days ago or something like that, and it was it felt right, like he was encapsulating the emotion of the moment effectively. Rec is a very talented individual, as you know.
Yeah, he's all right, man. He has a new EP out today. Make sure you check it out.
He's all right, man.
He's up and coming. You know what I'm saying?
He is.
You know.
I'm Meridian Point, right? Is that what his shit's called? Meridian Point. I hope I got that right.
Pretty on point. Like, he's all right. You know what I'm saying?
He's pretty.
Pretty on point.
Damn.
Meridian Point. He's pretty on point. Yo.
That's amazing.
Finding Fino or Fino, I don't know, wants to ask, are you making more music with the Palmer Squares?
Yeah, man. Sorry, I didn't mean to step out of frame. I'm pouring myself some coffee. Yeah, I'm definitely making some more music with the Palmer Squares.
They got trashed in here yesterday, by the way.
Oh, the Squares got trashed?
Bro, we played their Hard Knock TV freestyle from like 7, 8 years ago.
Ooh.
And they like tried to redo Broken Language by Trigger the Gambler and Smooth the Hustler.
I know what you're talking about. I'm a sharpshooter, the dumb shooter, the sump looter.
They tried to redo it.
I thought they did that, you know? What'd you think?
I'm going to remain anonymous.
Oh, shit.
But the chat ate their lunch.
Wow.
I will say this. I'm glad I wasn't introduced to them via that freestyle because they're amazing.
Haven't you always wanted to do that style? I was like mad when I saw that they did it. I was like, damn, I always wanted to do that.
Then you should do it. I think you and I think you and Gotti would kill that.
That shit's over 20 years old, right? Didn't that come out in the 90s?
Yeah.
Sometime? I don't remember when.
Yeah, in the 90s.
We look to you for these things. You're like the hip hop lexicon.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. No, that was 90.
That came out
94. I'm gonna look it up, but
I bet you nailed it.
Let's see, Broken Language. Shit, it was good enough to make them Ice-T's best friends for the rest of their lives. They don't have to work.
That's tight. That's a win.
Yeah, they still going to. I saw them at a sound set with him.
Really?
Oh, I was wrong. 96.
96. That's a good year though.
Vintage.
I heard it on like a DJ Rectangle mixtape. First time I heard that.
DJ
joint.
Rectangle. He used to be, I think he used to be Warren G's DJ. Wait, how do you
Bro,
have a song
that's
called
where I discovered
this?
Eminem as well was Rectangle. First time I heard Eminem.
Wow. How do you, okay, Warren G has a song called This DJ, and he's also a DJ. He has a DJ. Why does a guy that is a DJ have a DJ? This DJ's called Warren G. But then you have a DJ.
With DJ Rectangle backing him up.
I don't get it, bro.
I don't know, man. Warren had to come to the front. You know what I mean?
Yeah, he had to come to the front, so he had to have Rectangle have his back. What's next for you? What's next project dropping?
Next project. That's in the works. I can't give you a name or a date or none of that shit. I can't tell you that I probably am going to work with the Palmer Squares. Maybe put them on there.
Okay.
We have one that's not out right now. Yeah. I'll just say that.
You got a gym.
We have one that we already did that I think that it belongs to them. They're going to put it on something that's not out yet. And as like a follow-up to The Quill, which was on Under Bad Influence, my album. So I don't know. And that, it's tight. I can't wait till it drops. So yeah. I think I might do one on the new thing.
We're getting some new shit. All right. Well, now
and they're better than they were 8 years ago, as I hope we all are. You know what I'm saying?
According to my chat, let's just put that in there.
It's tough. I mean, bro, I've got. Do you have some old stuff where it's like?
Oh like, yeah, everything. Unfortunately, it's all on the streaming platform, and it makes me money every month, so I can't get rid of it.
Yeah, I wouldn't tear it down. I got stuff that I'm not proud of that makes me money that I'm going to leave it up. It ain't that deep, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, nah, fuck it. The people see my growth. That's what I think. You know what I mean?
That's what they tell me, too. They're like, I like to see how you came from this to that. And I'm like, okay, well, as long as you're entertained.
Yeah, that's the point. Mm-hmm. And right now, we're going to entertain the people with a video of yours called What If?
Oh, dang. Another one of my videos? Yes. Let's go.
This is called What If? I think if I can get it right.
Produced by Michael Seven Summers, who you did a whole album with.
Good afternoon, good evening. This is DJ Don Satipica up here at WTIF.
Denver mayor admits that he's regulating marijuana effectively.
And is it playing now?
We are happy to hear about that.
Up next, What If?
Yes, playing.
Stay woke, keep your brain in the clouds, revolution up.
Stay woke, keep your brain in the clouds. Where did you get those dreadlocks? Are those your real dreadlocks?
For sure. That's actually my real hair. I usually just wrap it up and put it under a dad hat when I'm in public.
That was scary.
What if I was tripping?
It's a lot of hair. That was crazy. I think that was like the Dread Pirate Roberts. That's his name, right?
No, not Captain Jack. I don't know. Jack Sparrow, Pirate Roberts.
Jack Sparrow, fucking Jack Sparrow. Yeah, it was like a Jack Sparrow wig, I think. The Dread Pirate Roberts. That's a whole different pirate. You know what I'm saying?
Hold on, let me turn it up for a second so people can hear you bar up.
Yeah. I got bars on this one.
Record sales was at a record loss. That's a fucking hard pill to swallow. Why accept the cost? Who the fuck was left? Still qualified to check the boss. I've been waiting for this moment all my life. Respect the sauce. I am the product of disorganized, reckless thoughts. I'm here to ask what the important kind of questions are. We got a second score from Lauren Y, Clef and Pross. Lee Harvey's second shot was 4 or 5 seconds off. The government was really at the people's beck and call. What if they make a list of names and try and check us off?
Okay, was it when they were waterboarding you? Was that dangerous? Did you think that you were gonna die?
When they were waterboarding me?
Yes.
I mean, I did ask to be authentically waterboarded. I asked for basically everything you're seeing in the video is pretty authentic, with the exception of electrocution. We didn't really do that, but we did have the car battery hooked up to the jumper cables. We was throwing some real sparks, but you know, he never actually shocked me, of course.
Okay.
But yeah, I did get waterboarded. It was like waterboarding light, though. It was like the Michelob Ultra of waterboarding.
Oh, shoot. I have an important tip for someone I just read on the internet, thanks to Mac Lethal.
What's that?
If you're going to drink Michelob Ultra, just drink it in the bathroom. That way you don't have to run to the bathroom every 5 minutes to piss.
Oh, that's a good tip.
There you go. Back to your bars.
Yeah, back to the bars, I suppose. This video was pretty cool. I didn't have myself tipped backwards. You know, you're supposed to be low-key, almost upside down when you get water.
dueling bars. Well, how do you know that? Are you a Navy SEAL?
I studied up very, I was very, I had a very watchful eye over the Bush administration. In general, from 2000 to 2008, I watched the government a lot and read up on everything that was happening in those years. So that's to answer your question. That's how I know about waterboarding.
I don't like seeing you with blood coming out of your mouth, so we're going to stop that video right there. But it's called What If. It's a really dope-ass song.
There was a shot I had to censor out of this video because they decided it was too graphic.
Oh, what was that? What was the shot that got censored?
I think that we got this far. I'm kind of watching the feed after the fact on delay or whatever, but there's like a robbery, like kind of in the middle of the song. I walk up in a black hood and sunglasses and like rob a woman pushing a stroller or whatever. So in the original version, she was shot in the face after the robbery is finished. She got shot like point blank in the face. And they said it was too much.
Yeah, I think so. Cobweb in the chat wants to give you props, however, for water. He said waterboarding is waterboarding. You manned up for that. Did you do your own stunts?
Yeah. I have no stuntman.
Okay. All right.
I wasn't doing anything too crazy. I did get like all duct taped, like hands and feet duct taped and thrown in a trunk. That was all real. And then they threw me over the edge of a bridge into water. That was real. So I had a grown man in only his boxer shorts catch me in the water and cradle me like a baby. while my hands and feet were tied.
Did you suckle his teat?
I didn't, but there was an opportunity that passed me. You know what I'm saying?
You side-eyed the nipple.
It was there. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I was like this, and I was kind of like, I kind of look like this. You know what I'm saying?
Oh man, yeah. When I threaten to breastfeed off of my wife, my little ones get a little upset. That's their territory. Dang. But I wonder what it would be
Everybody
like.
Everybody has to share. You know.
So look, man, how did we meet? I don't even remember, man.
So, I met you, and then I like re-met you.
Okay.
When I started to like do good at rap or whatever. But so I re-met you at Paid Dues.
Okay. Yes.
You know, and you were fucking busy. And there was like a mile long line of people that were getting your autograph at a booth.
Yes.
You know, and then you like stepped away from that for a second and then met me. And then I had like such a fan experience with you. That I was like, no, like I wanted more. You were like, you had me sign my album for you.
Oh, you yeah. Like, yeah. You yeah.
So I was like, well, yeah. And I signed it and you're thank you so much. I'm like, you're welcome. And then it was like, peace. I was like, what the fuck? You know? You know?
I remember that. Okay. I'm not that bad. But when did we meet before that? In KC? Vinyl Room?
Scribble Jam.
Wow. Scribbly dibbly jam.
Yeah, probably like 2002 or 2003, one of those years. It was the year that you you like ambushed Idea.
Sucker punched him.
Yeah, and with a freestyle, with a battle freestyle on stage. If you kind of remember doing that.
Oh yeah, it's on all on the YouTubes.
Yeah, it's on all the YouTubes. I had met you that year, but it was just like just a quick meeting, like, oh, what's up, dap, and you know,
rap dappity, rappity dappity.
And I knew you from your team. You know what I'm saying?
From Living Legends.
From Living Legends, yes.
Legends, baby.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I remember you guys did Pay Dues. Some last minute shit, huh? Because you guys were just on the bus, right?
Yes, and you were kind enough to plug us into the lineup. I don't remember what the name of the stage was, but we had a really interesting slot that was between Sugar Free and Killer Mike.
Wow.
And I think Swollen Members dropped out.
Yes.
And we filled their slot, and it was dope.
Another black and white group.
Yep. Maybe people thought we were Swole members. Some people.
I know. Definitely. There's at least 50 people in the crowd that thought that for sure.
They were like, "Damn, Mad Child looks mad different." You know what I'm saying?
Zero tattoos. Mad Child looks mad different.
What happened to it? What happened to his face? His face.
Oh man.
Yeah, he must have makeup on. I don't know. Yeah.
Wait, what's the other guy's name? And I forget. I want to call him Approach, but I know Approach is not that. Approach is a Kansas rapper.
That's right. Shout Approach is my market. Dude, it escapes me, which is fucked up.
Who's the other guy in Swole Members chat? Now we gotta wait for the lag. Killer Mike's the other dude.
And Killer Mike, by the way, I was watching him rap. I think that he and LP were probably just starting to cook up Run the Jewels that year.
Yeah.
Hadn't been dropped yet, you know what I'm saying? And to me, Killer Mike's show was a little weird. I'd never seen him or whatever, and I watched him perform, and I was like, "Word," and it felt off in some way to me.
Prevail is the other dude in Swollen Members.
Oh, for real, Prevail and Mad Child. Okay.
All right, let's we're supposed to go into another video. Oh, well, we've been on tour together. I don't know. Yeah, this motherfucker Vic didn't write that question in there.
Damn, he didn't say anything about that?
Nah. Our first tour together was the Merch Day tour.
It was.
Do you have any stories you'd like to share with the general public about that?
Oh, what could I say about the Merch Day tour? That was really fun. That was awesome. That was the only bus tour that I've been on where it was just one bus. As opposed to a village of buses.
A bus village. A village.
A village, if you willage.
That tour, did I take everybody to see John Wick?
Yeah, John Wick 1?
Yeah, hold on 1 second. Miss Fatty, 6745, welcome to the Mercenaries. I didn't think we were going to get any subscribers today. Thank you very much.
Hey, we caught a sub. Let's go.
And if you have Twitch Prime, you can subscribe for free. If you don't, you can subscribe for a fee. But either way, you get to request videos every day when we're not doing the green room. But now, Miss Fatty, any question you want answered, go for it. But back to this thing. So I stick everyone to see John Wick. And I hated it.
Yeah. Oh, I'm getting her chat after the fact. I see it.
Did you like John Wick when you first saw it?
I did. Yeah. And it became like a whole theme of the tour.
Gotti wouldn't shut up about the lyrical John Wick. Baby Ripgut, welcome to the Mercenaries.
You said what?
So you like the movie? Oh, were you getting lag? Can you hear me? Uh-oh. Fuck. Did we fuck up?
Uh-oh. Did we freeze up?
Yeah. Can you hear me through Skype? Or are you watching the stream? I think the sub train knocked us out. Damn. I'm gonna try to call you back. Oh, damn, Mr. Fatty. I said Miss Fatty. I'm fucking up, yo. I'm so sorry. Yubi, can you hear me? Make a face. All right. Mr. Fatty, I'm so sorry, bro. I fucked your whole life up. I'm about to call Yubi back. All right. We're going to call his ass back. All right. Now, let's see if we get the F's in the chat. I fucked that up. I'm trying to watch UB. All right, let's see. bitch.
Back again?
Maybe. The video's not coming through.
Nicholas.
All right.
Hey.
Yes. Can you hear me now?
I can hear you.
Okay, cool.
I can see your picture that looks like you should have been in that movie Us. You know what I'm saying? You were looking at me like that, B.
Follow Baby Rip Gut.
Oh, that's Triz.
Yeah. He came to a session. So you like John Wick. Mr. Fatty didn't like John Wick.
I liked it. John Wick. We saw a couple movies that tour. If I'm not mistaken, it was like that one. Me and you went and saw Hero 6.
Oh, Big Hero 6. Oh, and then later, you bought me a Big Hero 6 shirt.
Big facts. Big Hero facts.
When we went out, when I brought you guys out here to record an album or try to record some music.
Oh, we came up and bought a bunch of beats. Actually, that's the picture I put up
today. Noah Rockefeller and Triz and me and you.
Yeah. We were beat shopping with you that day. You recorded some shit that day. It was tight.
Yeah, I was doing Camp in California back then.
Yeah, yep.
Had to get you guys out of the strange studio.
It was very refreshing. I would love to do that again.
Yeah, I bet.
Yeah, man, that was good fun.
Fuck, man. So then, we saw Big Hero 6, and then we saw
Interstellar.
Interstellar.
Was that the same tour?
No, I don't think Interstellar was that tour. I don't know. Let's look it up.
I saw that shit with Mayday then.
Interstellar. Fuck Mayday.
We couldn't stop talking about the fucking Tesseract.
Interstellar. Wait. 2014? No, I was on that tour. We had to see it together.
It was, huh? In the fall of 2014?
Yeah, fall of 2014.
That was the Interstellar tour.
Interstellar was released October 26, 2014.
Definitely.
November 4th, actually. Sorry, November 4th, 5th. It was... Yep, November 5th. That was it. Sorry. It keeps getting later and later.
It does.
And when did the Merch Day tour happen?
2014 in the fall.
Yes. Yeah, that was a fucked up. That was the worst tour of my life. You were on the worst tour of my life.
Damn, I had some good memories though. We went go-karting. There was some high points.
Oh yeah, no, definitely. I always try to make sure any tour I go on, like, fun is definitely high up on the list.
Uh-huh. I definitely got some good memories of that. We low-key met the Palmer Squares on that tour, unbeknownst to all of us, I think.
Oh, why?
We played Minneapolis this one day in this room that was like, I don't know, like a 2000 cap or something.
Yeah, that's the night in the fucking snow at the Skyway.
The Skyway Theater, totally.
Yep.
Remember, and we should not have been in that spot, and we were in that spot or whatever, and the Squares were there too, bro, and they were just, I remember talking to them, and they're like, we're opening? And I was like, bro, I don't know who you're supposed to sound check with or what. You know what I'm saying?
That was a fucked up. Yeah, see, that was one of the reasons. Worst tour ever.
Mm-hmm.
That night, we had some random girls came on the bus that were stewards, like in stewardess school or something.
Word?
Yeah, and I was just like asking them all kind of questions. Like, yo, do we really have to sit down when the fucking fasten seatbelt sign is on, or do I get to take a piss? And they were like, look, we can't stop you from taking a piss. Because I wasn't messing around. I was married. So I was just like, fuck it. Like, I'm just going to ask them the most in-depth questions about flight safety regulations.
Damn, why are you always trying to test the fence up there, Merz? You know what I'm saying? We 30,000 feet up. You trying to test regulations?
Bro, I'm getting to that age where the prostate and shit, I got to go to the bathroom, bro. And I'm not trying to
fucking
Like, it's either I don't drink 2 hours before the flight and I can't drink during the flight, or I hydrate myself like a responsible human being and I get up and pee when I want to. I take the aisle seat so I don't have to fucking excuse myself.
Right. So you plan for this. It's fine. They know what it is. You know what I'm saying? They're not going to drag you off the plane like United and beat your ass and then drag you off the plane like that it did United, you know?
I hope not, man. Not for taking a pee-pee, man.
No, definitely not. Only for being an Asian doctor. You get beat up for stuff like that.
United.
On United, yeah.
Not so United. On flying, not so United.
Divided, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, man. All right. We're just having a conversation. I was supposed to be doing an interview.
Oh, we could do questions.
No, now we're supposed to watch Blunt and a Ho.
Oh, this song's tight.
That time we rapped together.
Yeah.
That one time we kicked rhymes.
I still perform this song semi-frequently to this day.
Really?
And people really like it, yeah.
Oh, speaking of, highlight of the tour was when we got to go and do our Strange Music Cypher on the road.
Very tight, very tight.
I think we're the most, like, don't ask me why, we never, ever did a whole tour with everybody. That would have been nice. To do there's always touring with a village full of buses. There should have been a tour to me at the peak of Strange, and I could be biased, but when it was me, Ritz, you know, everybody, and we should have all done the cypher live at least once.
But that would have been amazing, dude.
I think we're the most Strange, the most complete Strange cypher ever performed, because there was five of us.
Yeah, that's the most members I ever did of that song.
And we would jump in the crowd every night and do it. I love doing that. Felt so good, man. Pause.
Oh my God, I remember one night though, you son of a bitch.
What happened? See, now it's coming up. What did I do?
We were in Mexico. We were in New Mexico. We were in like Farmington or something like that, right? And it's like native country. It's a very I think it might even be on native land. I'm not even sure. You know what I'm saying? But we're in like native country in Farmington, New Mexico. And they're just so turned up. They're so passionate. You know what I'm saying? And we were in this performing at like a Red Lion Hotel, and it was hot and sweaty, and it was mad people there. It was packed, right? It was a party. And the stage was really high, like to where their heads were at our feet level. Right, they're like looking at our shoes, and I remember we were here. The cypher was coming on, and I leaned into you, and I was like, "Bro, do not jump in the crowd, bro." And then you straight jumped in the crowd right after I said that. You know what I'm saying? You jumped right into the crowd, no hesitation.
And what happened? Did it go bad after that?
It was super thugged out. We were like trying to do crowd control. We were like, it was pulsating, and we were like, like trying to hold people back, not get punched in the face while we were doing the cypher. It was wild, bro. And yeah, we got manhandled doing the cypher that night.
I don't think I knew. Like that was, cause that's, I done Farmington once with Tech on Psychology, and it was a sports bar, and at that point, we had more people there than Tech had at the sports bar. I think because the sports bar wasn't all ages.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know, bro.
The passion is real.
Bro, the passion of the Tech. The passion of Strange. Bro.
It was super real.
Yo. All right. I'm you guys sorry.
Pick that day.
I'm sorry.
It's all right.
Yes, back to this video.
Oh, Blunt and a Ho, we're on. This shit off enough to not take me away
to do big bids, so I say that to Tech does have on a red bandana. Say that I'm straight building, but it really hurts when the government take millions. Since I was shady, had
this, to make children the same time when they this video is based million. Off so of Cheech and Chong.
Yes. To be sure your daughter
stay steady enough to and you me. Are be the problem, Cheech. Other things here to curse me. Merit. Girl so much, not doing the shit to in this video. Wife, he cheated after I didn't speed it. My life is a red hot chili pepper. I eat it like I'm Anthony Kiedis. I'm heated. So just like a man, I resort to my penis. So check it out. I got a blunt. I ain't about to spend my whole day stuck in the funk, so I'm about to get drunk.
sitting right on top of me with that incredible blunt. So check it out, I got a blunt.
Stuck in the funk, so I'm about to get Tech 9 is that guy that will, when you don't smoke weed, he will put you on the weed song. You know what I'm saying? Status festival called
but I never fully got paid. Yeah, he will. Die arrest, though they think I
did. And now they after the kid shit. And I'm the only one in my household that go to work. Ain't getting no pussy, so now I got a jerk. Feeling like a jerk, and that ain't never gonna work. Playing positive, but ain't getting none of the perks. What to do when your IG popping off Snapchat got
who's this guy? Oh, it's Burns. She is this, dick. This is like a Merce Day video with featuring UB and Tech. And I ain't trying to be no martyr boss.
Fuck around and see them piss Nick Carter off. Burns is like hiding in the couch cushions. Now I finally got a good alibi, so check it out. I
got a blunt. Alright, I'm gonna fast forward to your part. UBI, UB fly, but UB lying to me. True, she dying to see where I was and what happened. Studying social media, she trying to catch him.
Dang, this video's tight. With the condom off, let it hit. Now my dick feel like it falling off.
Sperm. Did you have relations with this model here? Word to my mama, I'm disturbed by a lot
of bra. That's word to mother, son. I can't say that I did. Maybe she make me come a
lot, but I come at a cost. Can't say that you didn't either. I lost. We'll never reconcile. She play me like a pawn for the record. So check it out. I got a blunt.
Nope. Spend my whole day stuck in the funk, so I'm about to get drunk. Sitting right on top of me with nah, I was a greasy cop that day. It's not an attractive role, you know? I am about to spend my whole day stuck in the funk, so I'm about to get drunk.
Sitting right on top of me with that incredible rump, so check it out. Oh, man. Boss man. All right, so that's it, y'all. That's Blunt in a Hoe.
That video's tight.
Yeah, I thought we did a good job. With our raps there.
You set me up on that. You did. You had a live say what to do when your IG popping off. You know.
What did I do? What was that?
You did that style, and when the song got to me, it was on there. I was like, oh, and I kind of did that style in my verse too.
Oh man. Well, I'm glad I can influence you.
It was tight. It was tight. I don't know what my favorite song is that we've done together. How many songs? We might have five or six songs.
Really? Yeah, we got the funeral with Slug, Felt right. Crew. We got Blunt and Noho.
Yep.
What else do we have? Strange Creature was a creature for your album.
Strange Creature. And then you did another one on a Cess Crew record called Metal and Flesh.
Metal and Flesh. Mm-hmm. Finding Fino, welcome to the Mercenaries.
We got a sub?
Yep. Three subs, man. Thank you. My mom wants me to call into a radio station. Hold on. Trent, that's four. What is your favorite of those four?
Of those four, I don't know. Well, and then we got the Cypher too, you know, which I think counts.
Five. Hot five. Yo, that's an EP.
Hot five. I really like Strange Creature. We were doing Strange Creature on the MERS Day tour.
Yeah, that was fun.
We were bringing you out every night, like having the crowd chanting Living Legend.
Yeah.
And you came out and we did this thing where we prayed. It was tight. That song went off live somehow. We made that shit go
off. I think
that
was one of the best, as far as like a lineup and performances, like that was one of the best tours. Like the actual things we had control over, the performances were dope.
It felt like a full, like calculated package. Like the whole thing worked together. Y'all performed you performed as Cops and Robbers when you guys came out as MERS Day. You know what I'm saying? So it was, you felt like a show, man. Felt like a real show. That shit was tight.
Yeah. I liked it, man. I'm all for more, you know, if we could do that again, just with better management of, not better with management, just better routing. I don't know, better booking. How about that?
Better booking. Jose did a good job TMing. I remember that.
He's the best.
Jose is the best.
Tiger King. You want to talk about it?
Oh, I haven't seen it. Marmo texted me, told me to watch it. I haven't watched it yet, but I've seen the previews on Netflix.
Yeah.
Did you watch it?
I watched a part of the first one. It's crazy. It's crazy. It's crazy. It's worth it if you got time.
It's deeper than him owning Tiger. He's like a murderer. He's like above the law or something. He's doing some weird shit.
I don't know, man. I don't want to ruin. No spoilers. You know what I'm saying?
Okay. Okay. Fair enough.
Just recommended watching. And then here, I think we're going to end it with this question because we've been on here for an hour. Sorry for taking all your time.
You know what? I don't have much of shit to do.
Yeah. Right.
it's quarantine. So it's all good.
Your boy is on quarantine. Nah, I mean.
Yep.
Ladies and gentlemen, you can feel free to participate in this one. But I think you're my age, so I'm not going to be surprised by this answer.
We're pretty close in age.
As far as Midwest MCs go, there's a small town called Chicago.
Sure.
Where a majority of the Midwest MCs come out of that are on the national scale.
Yes.
Who is the better MC out of Chicago? Lupe? Or Common?
I really like both of them. I would have to give it to Common as the forefather in the situation. Just because probably they're Common low-key paved the way for a person like Lupe to even do what he did. So he probably fathered him in a way, not like, you know what I'm saying. Just that he broke the ground in Chicago.
He broke the ground. And the ground is very cold in Chicago.
Dude. And he definitely put Chicago on the map. Actually, back in the day, I only really remember Common was the rapper from Chicago. It's like,
yeah, out of a fucking metropolis, there was one. That's when you know shit is real in the neighborhood. People should have known Chicago was trill as fuck when there's millions of black people living in there and there's only one rapper on a national level coming out of there.
Right, it's just Common.
That means there's a lot of trill shit going on in those neighborhoods.
Man. But his records at the time, especially Resurrection and One Day It'll All Make Sense, to me, were like pivotal hip hop records of the era and for the region and like sort of starting a Midwest movement. So I got to give it to him. I really love Lupe Fiasco though. And I would say that both of those guys are super influential on my personal style and development, how I do my craft for sure.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. I respect both of them. But what Common also has to me is that classic albums in two era, B and Finding Forever and Resurrection and, you know, Like Water for Chocolate, I think, or One Day It All Makes Sense. You know what I mean? He has great albums in two eras, you know?
Yeah, yeah, he does. I mean, B was like an official reestablishment of like, yo, I'm still here and I still can kill it. And B was an amazing album. Might have had a lot to do with Kanye West, who kind of, you know.
Yeah, but I think there, but when you have Kanye, even that, who's better over Kanye production?
It was genius.
Like, and
it
Lupe, was set Lupe up. And Common have both rapped over Kanye beats.
Yeah.
And I think Common did him more justice, man. I'm just going to throw that out there.
He had the whole, it was exclusively produced by Kanye.
That's true. That's true. Lupe didn't get that look.
He didn't get that look, but he didn't get and it was like the magic era. Like it was like, you know, like college dropout going into like whatever, like graduation. That era is when B dropped. And so John Legend is on a song and just good music is starting to form. Like that was crazy. That was crazy at the time. Like super crazy. Yeah. You couldn't do better than have a whole album produced by Kanye West at that very moment.
At that, yeah. Prime timing.
Yeah.
So overall, are you saying that Kanye is better than both of them? Is that what you're saying? Can I get you on record with that?
I don't think anybody's taking the city higher than Kanye.
Ooh, touch the sky.
Yeah, he touched the sky for sure. And he's still pooping. Which had Lupe on it, which kind of put Lupe in the game. And so, you know, when you think about him birthing or sort of opening a lane for so many of these guys, even Chance the Rapper, who's super, like, occupying the lane currently. Chance could, I mean, if Chance does another 10 years the way he's going right now, he could be like a new Kanye, maybe.
And I don't think there's a producer who has, I don't know how many, like, gangster projects Kanye has produced on, but Kanye is on Dre level when it comes to touching MCs from his region. Like, yeah. Chance, Lupe, and Common. But then you bring up Cudi.
Chance, would you say Pusha, Chance and what?
Chance, Lupe, and Common, like, out of Shy. Like, he's birthed or touched, like, helped shape three greatest.
I lost you again.
Oh, shit. Fuck it, y'all. We gotta call him back just to say goodbye.
Oh, yeah, but I see in the chat here.
Kanye might be one of the greatest producers ever. Hold on. We're gonna call you back. I wish I could tell him make a face.
Oh, I can hear you, though.
You can hear me now?
I can.
Okay, cool. All right, we talked too much, man.
See people talking about No ID in the chat.
No ID can't touch Kanye. I love No ID, though, but just unfortunately with hits and stuff. But 444 is a great album.
Maybe I can't hear you.
Okay. Fuck it. I'm going to call him back. All right. Calling him back.
No.
Let him do his thing, bro. We lost him, y'all. We're gonna try him one more time and see what the fuck.
Okay, are we back?
Yep, we're back.
Bow.
But let's go back and then get a goodbye out of you.
Yeah, sure.
Let you drink your coffee, maybe take your medicine in peace.
I'm not taking meds yet. I'm fit as a fiddle currently.
No, I'm talking about medicinal marijuana.
Oh, yeah, I wouldn't. Yeah, I might do that after this.
I know you don't use it for recreational purposes. You use it for the medicinal purposes.
Yeah, I just happen to take my medicine on a recreational frequency. Oh, yeah.
Okay, well, I have a Patreon. You should come to Patreon.
Man, I think I'm going to have a Patreon very soon. I really like what's going on over there.
So, yeah. And until then, make sure you check out Ubiquitwits.
Yeah, Ubiquitwits. I might be on streaming later playing Apex Legends. It'll be pretty cool.
Yep. Is your son better than you at Apex Legends?
No, but he's better than me at Smash Brothers in an embarrassing way to where I can't play with him anymore.
Okay. Yeah, don't play with him, son. Don't play with your son.
It's too damaging to my ego. It's like it was doing real psychological damage to me. I had to fall back.
You had to take your medication.
Yep. I had to go take my meds and reflect, you know?
Oh, man. Super Smash Fathers. Yeah, we talked about that yesterday.
We did, briefly.
Starzy Cat says, definitely go on Apex.
Go on Apex. Okay, come see me on Apex in a minute, y'all. I'll tell you what, if you're bored, I don't know, we don't have it set up to where you can raid me yet, right?
I think so. Can we raid him? I'll ask Bombshelter. Can we raid UB once he starts playing that? That'll be a perfect send away. I'll play a couple videos for the people. And then you'll get set up, and then we'll raid you.
Yep, I'm gonna fire it up right now, baby.
Fire it up.
Whoa. Did you find a bishop?
Uh-oh. Sarah Dope says there's lots of things that are broken.
You want the thing
lost? Sam, what up?
What?
Do
you want the other thing?
How come Sarah Dope don't want to play Apex Legend with us?
Ooh, because she's scared. That's right. When are you getting on some shit with King Iso?
Bruh, King Iso is on my record Under Bad Influence. Hello.
What are you doing, Mobs 12?
Mobs 12, check this out, man. There's a song called Get Busy. It's me, King Iso, Locksmith.
Ooh, that's a lot of bars.
And Jaron Benton, all on one track. Hello.
240 C's, what's up? Bishop, can you pass me your iPad? Guys, I know what the culprit is of the dropping of the frames.
What are you doing?
We got to take it off the internet right now. You're using up all my internet. I can't do my job. Uncle Yubi's over here suffering because of your crafting.
Minecrafting?
Yes. So, yep, boom. Watch that. No more drop frames. Mobs wonder how he missed that, man. Stop sneaking out albums, man. Tell the people when the albums drop so that they can hear your bars with Locksmith and King Iso.
Damn, I will have to tell them. So Under Bad Influence dropped it last in July of 2019. It's a full-length album, and it's got amazing features on it. Unfortunately, no Murs, even though we got so many different collaborations.
We have enough now. I think we said five.
It's probably five. It could be six. I don't know. I'll have to look it up, you know.
You know,
you did that other song with Gottimus, though. Does that count? It was called Which One?
Which One? Pick One. No.
Yeah, you remember that?
What was that on? Pick Up Those
Crumbs. It was on It was on one of those Strange Elation records.
But then we had Bacon. We had, me and the Gotti had two together.
Oh, dang, and you had Bacon. See, it gets deep. If we count like cess ties.
Yeah, seven. I got seven.
Damn. We'd have made a couple things together.
Yeah, we just haven't had one, just me and you. Just me and you. Maybe we'll do it for my Patreon.
Yeah, that's a great idea.
Wait, do we have a... Didn't we... Did I send you guys a beat? Because I wanted... You did Metal and Flesh, and I was going to do Flesh and Metal. You guys did something under that, right?
We were talking about it, but then we never did do it. You know what? Now that I just thought about it, we secretly were on the Rick Grimes Is Dead song. But we talked about it behind closed doors, and I was kind of like, yo, this song is really tight, even without us on it. And so you just did it without us. You know what I'm saying? But we did submit verses. Do you recall that?
I got to look through my email. I'm just going to release them on my fucking Patreon tonight, if that's all right with you.
Dude, put it out. It's the remix. Let's go.
Yeah, we'll see what happens. If I get sued, I get sued. Who gives a fuck? I'm out here, bro.
Yeah, you ain't gonna get sued.
I ain't gonna get sued. I might not get booed. All right. Well, check it out, man. UB, are you up and streaming yet?
I actually have just gone live. I should be up.
Let's organize this raid.
I've never raided before. Have you done this?
I have great folks that do it with me. I have arms and legs and hearts and brains, and I have a team.
A whole team, even.
Yeah. And they will move you around and move me around. I might stay here and play a couple rap videos after I take a pee-pee.
That's cool.
Permission from my wife.
Sarah Dope is sending the MF Doom mask to the chat.
Yeah, whatever that means.
Hey, you did songs with that guy, didn't you?
Who?
Doom.
No, I never done a song with Doom.
Get the fuck out. No. I thought I could have swore.
I wish. I met him a couple times. I know him.
Okay. But, okay.
That's about it.
Never you met him mask off? Mask off or mask on?
Both.
Okay.
Both. Yeah. He's an interesting guy, man. He's one of my heroes.
Are you aware of the Hannibal Buress situation?
No, what?
I guess there was a Doom concert and Hannibal Buress showed up and did the show in the Doom mask, and they found out it was him and that it wasn't Doom.
Oh, wow, that's hilarious.
Once, you know, it's not the first time we've heard of these mask antics, but it's a more recent one, maybe last couple years sometime.
Yeah, okay. I saw that. I thought he did it on purpose, but he's a nice guy. He popped up at my last Chicago show.
Hannibal?
Yeah.
Dang, that's fresh.
Yeah, it's one of my few celebrities. Bill Paxton and Hannibal Buress.
Bill Paxton.
Yeah.
Get out of my town. Wow.
Chet Weird Science. Rest in peace. That's my homie.
Wow.
Bro, wait. They say if I raid you, my stream is over.
Oh, that's the only way it happens? You shut the spring down and then it goes in?
We're doing it anyway. Is that the only way it happens? Bomb shelter, before we get out of here. You could raid while I piss, and then if I come back, I come back, and I'll deal with it. You know what I mean? But I want to raid with you. My kids start crying anyway. I have a kid that cries consistently, basically incessantly.
I hear that. That's not Bishop, right?
No, he doesn't do that shit. I have a fat baby, a crying baby, and a 7-year-old.
Right. Bishop's straight. He's basically on the adult team now.
Yeah. He's just, you know, bit of a spaz here and there.
A fat baby. I have a fat baby. Crying baby.
Yeah. We call one like the R&B baby and the trap baby.
Okay.
One is chill and one is turned up all the time.
Wow.
But more recently, the turned up has turned into a lot of tantrums.
Dang. You got to turn those tantrums into twerk sessions. You know what I'm saying? Let them twerk it out.
Twerk it out. Yeah. Do you have any father tips for me?
I think you're surpassing me in fatherhood. I mean, mine's older, but now you got three. Like you're juggling, you know? Like a court jester. I don't even understand three.
One could call me a juggalo.
One could. I don't know. I don't know how you're doing three. Rex said the same thing, and I was like, bro, you got twins? Good luck.
Good luck with that.
You're outnumbered, bro. It's not good. The odds aren't good.
Odds aren't in your favor.
not at all.
Not very Hunger Games. May the odds ever be in your favor.
Mm-hmm.
Do you have any books you'd like to recommend to chat?
Man. You know, I've been reading again and again and again The Art of War over and over again.
Oh, shit.
So I should recommend that.
Okay. I think some people should be on the lookout.
It's a
whoever you're going to war with.
Right? Haven't you read it? I feel like you read that book.
Sun Tzu, I've read a couple pages here and there, some quotes.
It's like a toilet book, meaning that you could sit on the toilet for 10 minutes and just read it from any point, start, middle, end, and just pick it up and read it and then put it down. You know what I'm saying? So I really like that about it. Art of War. I recommend it.
Art of War. All right. And now let's we're gonna raid you. So go on and get on your shit. Make a face before you get on your shit.
Yeah, and thank you so much for having me to the green room. I very much enjoyed it. And stay safe and wash your hands.
1, 2, 3. Make a face. All right, y'all. That was UBI. And we're going to raid him, and I may come back and do my thing later if I'm so allowed by the powers that be in my house. If not, I'll see y'all tomorrow. I love you. And, yeah. See, I didn't break that, sir. Here's an outro video. Thank you, Teddy B, for gifting 2 subs. Thank you, Baby Rip Gut, for subbing. Make sure you follow Triz. Mr. Fatty, sorry for calling you Miss Fatty, and we'll see you soon, or if not, we'll see you tomorrow. Damn, we got a sub when we were offline. Shout out to King, whoever the fuck, and shout out to CPTN Spacebug. Sorry, I fucked that up. Captain Spacebug, that took me a while to get. And yeah, y'all, go see Yubi. Say bye to everyone.
Bye.
Right here.
Bye.
Okay. Love you guys. Have a good night.